I pledge to safeguard property and violence.
Indian Constitution Day, which is being celebrated every year on 26th of November, and throughout the country we celebrate this day. And Professor Arvind Jasrotiya, the Dean, Faculty of Law and Registrar, University of Jammu, Professor Manju Jamwal, Director of the Law School, our distinguished faculty of the Law School, and the students who are here present in large number today. So let me say that it is a great moment and it's a matter of great honor that I am here today to be with you to celebrate this day. My greetings to all of you, and in fact the importance of this day has already been explained by Professor Manju Jamwal, and we are also, since you are all law students, so you must be aware of all these duties and responsibilities which we have as the citizens of this country. Now we have also taken a pledge that we will safeguard the interests and protect the interests of the country. I have read it out, and each one of you has read it out. So I think whatever we are supposed to do as citizens of this proud country, I think that's what is enshrined in our constitution, and these are the duties and responsibilities which each one of us has to shoulder, and we have to perform these duties. Now it has been a long time since the Constitution of India was adopted, and over all these years the efforts have been made to see that the dreams which were actually seen by our leaders of that time, and who over the period of last 75 years of our independence, we have been aiming at trying to see that our country progresses in all spheres. And today when we are also celebrating the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, that is 75 years of independence, at this stage also we are taking stock of what we have done in the last 75 years and how we are going to plan for next 25 years, what we will be doing when India becomes 100. So I think it is, you are in a period when, which is the, I would say, the best period which we ever would have. India is a country of youth. About 60% of our populations are young students, young people, youth. So it is full of energy, it is full of young potential boys and girls who can actually take this country forward and make it one of the best places in the world. So it is up to you now, because whatever is being done or whatever has been done earlier, which has come to you as heritage, I think it is your responsibility to uphold all those things, and also to see that how we can face the challenges. I very often say that the youth of today will have to face numerous challenges in future, and we are not aware of what kind of challenges would be there in future. As you must have seen that in the last 1.5 years we have been facing the challenge of COVID-19, and least did we know before the COVID-19 that there will be something like this pandemic. And suddenly this pandemic has caught us unawares, and at that time, as you know, that in the last almost 2 years now, everything was closed, and there was a challenge as to how to continue the educational system, and it was a big challenge. So all of you and most of you and most of us tried to overcome this challenge, and you know that we immediately shifted to the online teaching, which you had not thought before the COVID-19 problem, but we shifted to that. It was a challenge for all of us. Similarly, we don't still know, and COVID is still there, so it's not gone. But once it goes, you are not sure that you are not going to face another challenge of this type. Now it is said that in the next 50 years, each one of you will have to change your job thrice. Our times were different. and the times were that we were in a profession and we continued in that profession. But the kind of challenges you people will have to face, I think you have to be ready to change your profession. So you have to be prepared for that. And how do you prepare yourself? This is the best opportunity. I have been telling in the last meeting when I was in I think it was a moot court function or something. And I clearly said that this is the time for you to gain knowledge in different areas. And that is what the National Education Policy is also saying. Don't remain limited to your field only. Your area should be multidisciplinary, and there are opportunities at this moment of time. There are so many thousands and thousands of online courses which you can actually you can enroll yourself, you can register yourself, and you can go through these programs, these courses, so as to make you a multifaceted personality. You never know, you may require tomorrow to or even in your profession, when you become the lawyers and advocates tomorrow, you may have to defend a case of DNA fingerprinting. So how many of you know that DNA fingerprinting is an evidence which nowadays everybody actually relies upon? Many decisions have been taken where the bodies have been exhumed and where the tests have been done, whether this is the same person who has been buried or not. Now, do you know anything how it is done? And if you don't know the technique, if you don't know the way it is done, you won't be able to defend the case. Therefore, for you, as a very simple example I have given, there are hundreds of such examples where you will be required to defend a case of a psychiatric patient. So you must understand what is happening in our brain, what are neurotransmitters. So therefore, my advice to you people would be that don't remain focused only on your field where you are. Try to see the world around you as well. And this day, today, while we are pledging for many things which are enshrined in our constitution, you must also, because I could see that the protection of women, equality, gender equality, accessibility, there are so many problems which we are facing. And today, while I am here, I am also attending simultaneously a conference, which you may be doing when you were attending the classes, in the online classes.
Sir, myself is Dr. Bindu Sangra. Today is a Constitution Day, very big event for the whole of India. And most important, I am a constitutional teacher also. So I have written this book, which titled as Expanding Horizons of Article 21 of Indian Constitution, A Critique. Agar aap is book mein jayenge, to aapko different facets of Article 21 ke milenge. As this is one of the most important fundamental right, which is given by the Constitution. As it says, no person can be deprived of life and personal liberty except procedure established by law. And I would like to share with everybody that this fundamental right is so important that this cannot be even taken during the emergency. This is one of the backbone of the fundamental rights. This article is just not about the right to life and personal liberty. Even everything which included within the definition of right to life and personal liberty, this book is all about that. This book contains all the aspects of the right to life and personal liberty. This, if you go through this book, I will definitely assure you that you will get to know the different rights which are included within the right to life and personal liberty.